Hey everyone, it's Nicole, and I'm doing a Let's Play video for Streets of Rage. Streets of Rage is one of my favorite series from the Genesis era. And although Streets of Rage 1 is probably my least favorite of the three, I thought I would go ahead and give it another try, since I don't play it very often. For one thing, I find it to be considerably harder than later games, partially just because of the limitations. You don't have the moveset that you do in Streets of Rage 2 or Streets of Rage 3. Alright, we'll get started. I don't expect to beat the game this time, just because I'm not all that great at this game. So, we'll see how far I get. Of course, I choose Blaze, who's one of my favorite characters of all time, certainly my favorite character in this game. I actually remember the first time I ever heard about Streets of Rage, or saw it. My mom actually bought this for my nephew for Christmas one year. I actually happen to be very close in age to many of my nieces and nephews. In fact, I have a niece that's a year older than I am, and my mom showed me what she bought my nephew, and it's like, wow, looks neat. And I wanted it for myself, but of course I didn't get it. Yeah, I didn't get it for myself until much later. But having played games like Double Dragon and maybe Final Fight by the time this came out, I was really interested in this game. And to this day, beat-em-ups are among my favorite genres of video games. One thing about this game, as opposed to Streets of Rage 2 or 3, I actually don't think that weapons help out. At least for Blaze, she seems to swing them slowly, so I usually avoid them. I think one reason I don't like this game as much is that at times it seems kind of cheap. Like in the later levels, you'll get surrounded by a bunch of enemies and they will just go nuts on you. And there's not a good way to escape that in this game unless you use your special. And of course, in this game, you have a limited number of those specials. Let's see if I can grab a hold of him. Probably not. I hate this guy. Wasn't too bad. Getting a little better. If you're unfamiliar with Streets of Rage, you may notice how good the music is in this game. It's definitely known for that. In fact, within the last year, I think, they actually... I haven't looked into this very much, but apparently the soundtrack has been released on vinyl, as well as maybe Shinmu? I'm gonna get the knife. Sure why female villains in these games always have to be in, like, dominatrix gear. That's a little bit of a generalization, but they seem to love to give the female characters whips. Dragon. It's the case in most, let me see, definitely Streets of Rage and Streets of Rage 2. I can't remember Streets of Rage 3. Thank you. that happen. Levels down. They seem to use the side of the screen a lot in this game, more than others, but maybe I'm just imagining that, but it seems that enemies constantly move away and off screen so you can't get to them. That the meat doesn't get off screen. Ah! have to say, other than the red-headed enemies, none of the regular enemies are that tough. Of course, when they get in large numbers, that changes things. But usually, I don't have many problems with anyone other than the red-headed guys who sometimes just come in quickly and manage to get in a lot of hits on me. Like that. Oh, that was... this guy. I will die at least once against him. I did better than I thought I would, if it weren't for the red-headed guy. Alright, first life lost. I have to say, I like Blaze's outfit better in this than I do in maybe Streets of Rage 2 or 3. Well, except for maybe the headband, that might be a little too 80s. In Streets of Rage 2, I can never figure out, like, what shoe she's wearing. They just look weird. At least here, they're obviously boots. I have to play a little bit smarter so I don't die through here. At least the enemies aren't as stupid in this game as they are in a game like Golden Axe, where you can actually get enemies to walk off a ledge and to their deaths. Which I do all the time in GoMax, even though it's a little ridiculous. Oh, how'd he get me? Oh! I don't know why I didn't land on my feet there. Die at least once on this guy. See if I get lucky. I can't believe it. I was certain I was going to die there. So for me, this isn't bad to get through the fourth round and only lose one guy. Another thing I don't like about this game is that you can't, at least not to my knowledge, throw a knife by just hitting both buttons the way you can in Streets of Rage 2. You have to be a certain distance from an enemy, and then it'll throw it automatically. At least, I think that's the case. That seems to be the case. Thank you. if I can get all these on one side. More damage than I'd like to. But I did get an extra life. Well, that was terrible. Oh my gosh! Oh, come on. I can't die twice against him. I have a lot of problems with him and with the boss that's coming up, which are the Blaze clones. Might as well use that before I die. It's not even worth messing with these guys. If I were playing two player, I might try to do that without using the special weapon, but thank you. Let's see how many times that I hear. Guessing at least twice. I just have yet to figure out what their weakness is. When I get close, they grab me before I can grab them. If I try to jump kick, they usually catch me in the air. I'm just at a loss when it comes to these two. But I managed to get a hold of her there, which is surprising. Feels cheap to use that, but I'm just not very good against these two. And I'm not sure why I didn't land on my feet there. Before she gets me. She quit jumping off screen. Oh, I can't believe I let him hit me. All things considered, that didn't go too badly. Definitely use that. I love using their own traps against them. Okay. That was getting ridiculous. Hopefully there's at least an apple coming up. time. Probably at least once here. Yeah, pretty guaranteed at this point. I'm gonna die at least once. Well, that was weird. As long as I can stay above him, yeah. This is the elevator stage, yes. Sadly, I will lose probably 2 to 3 lives here. Just because I get surrounded and... Already off to a pretty bad start. It is that every beat-em-up, well, that's a generalization, but almost every beat-em-up has some kind of elevator stage. I guess it's just a way to change up level design, but it's strange. I'm just gonna go ahead and use this, because I lose it if I don't, and I die. But back to the elevator stage, I don't know that I can think of a beat-em-up that doesn't have some kind of elevator stage. And I guess it makes it easier for, you know, design from a standpoint that, you know, really you're just designing this part of the level and changing the background up. What happened there? Where? I was hopeful for a second that I might not lose that other life on this level, but not that lucky. Hey, got a life back. So I've played this game... I've played this game twice recently. And neither time have I actually been able to make it to Mr. X. I keep getting stopped by the Blaze clones. I don't know if they have names or not. Because unlike Streets of Rage 2 or 3, there are no names displayed for enemies when you're fighting them. I wonder why those guys don't do the juggling animation when they're not actually juggling. Might as well get this before I lose it. At some point, I really do need to go into the sound test for this and just record all the songs. Okay, I have to stay above him. That's not the way to do it. Actually, it took me quite a... Oh my gosh. It took me a long time to figure out the best way to fight that guy. What? I don't know if I'm just not getting the button press in correctly, or what. But I should not be landing that way when I get thrown. Oh my gosh. For me, that's really good to get by him with only getting hit once. Maybe I'll actually make it to Mr. X this time. I'm trying to think if I've ever made it to Mr. X in this game. I'm curious if he fights the same as he does in Streets of Rage 2. Oh, I cannot believe I did that. I know better than that. Still not too bad. Say, at least they didn't put Blaze in thigh-high boots with a whip. They give her a really short skirt, but other than that, okay, let's make sure that I don't get knocked so far back. So I'm... Oh my god! Did that just happen? That was bad. That's ridiculous. I fully expected to lose a life right here. But fighting the Blaze clones, not against that guy. Wow. And here they are. And they take off a ridiculous amount every time they hit. Wow. I don't know what's going wrong with that. This is terrible. I'm astounded. I don't know what's going wrong with that move. So this is what happens every time. I get here, and then I cannot get past them. Maybe I have that move down wrong. I thought it was both buttons and up, but maybe it's different in this. Although it seems to work sometimes. Not that time. Seriously, I'm going to burn through all my continues trying to get past these two. Hey, I got one of them. Just take off so much. I mean, that one throw took off, what, half my health? And that happens. Why is her jump better? I don't know. I wonder how close she is. Probably not near close enough. Come on! Oh my gosh! Finally! How many waves I have to defeat before he comes out? Yep, he has the machine gun. So here we go, my last continue. Wow. Is there any chance I can get through this? I'm guessing not. Did I just beat Mr. X? Oh my gosh. That is the first time ever, I think, that I have beat the original Streets of Rage. Wow. I'm certainly getting better at it. I just came up with a good way to fight the Blaze clones. They are rough. I have to say, having played through it now, I do have a greater appreciation for the game. It's interesting to see just how it was built upon for Streets of Rage 2, which, as I said, Streets of Rage 2 is among my favorite Genesis games of all time. It's up there with Phantasy Star 2 and probably Sonic 2. You know, those games that I really liked when I initially had my Genesis. Anyway, that's it. Streets of Rage, the original for the Genesis. Thanks for watching.